it just didn't register what actually happened. I guess that's the best way to describe it. It's shock. You're shocked. And at that time, of course, the idea of saying the word terrorist or terrorism wasn't part of common language. It's part of common language now that we talk about terrorism. Isn't that something? Like, if you and I had met each other in 2000, or even in August of 2001, do you think you and I would have had the conversation we had downstairs about you traveling from Russia to here, or me going to visit you in Moscow? We would never talk about those things. So even flying, you know, in the United States, even if you wanted to fly to Florida, it's a process now. It doesn't matter where you go. You get on an airplane, 2 hours away, 25 hours away, it's a process now. Everything's changed. But in common language, the very idea of talking, having a conversation, just you and I, as regular people, about terrorists or terrorism or things we're seeing on TV all the time, people didn't talk like that. We didn't discuss those things. We weren't thinking like that. So the way that we think now, as citizens of the world, it's, you know, you're not an American, and we're talking like this. You talk about it with your friends, I'm talking about people I know, we're talking together, things are different.